In today's episode, we will be seeing the remaining portion of the oil rigs, and that is the part two of oil rig, which is the floating structures. Last time we have seen the fixed structures, which comprises of jacketed steel platform and many other type of rigs like jackup rigs and so on. So today we will be discussing the second category, which is basically designed for ultra deep and deep waters. So we will go ahead and see what are those categories. The floating structure platform is having four primarily different types of platforms, and that is tension leg platform first, second is spar platform, third is semi submersible platform, and fourth is the FPSO vessel, which is floating production, storage and offloading. The tension leg platform, which you can see, constitutes of the topside facilities, which has a drilling derrick, then a crane, and all the process and production facilities which are there in all types of platforms. Only the difference is in the way how it is mounted or connected to the seabed, or how it is positioned in a certain location in the waters. That is the only difference. Okay, so as we have seen in our earlier session, that it is not advisable, economically advisable, to construct, and also not practical to construct a fixed or complete rigid structure in ultra deep waters, maybe say 300 or 500 meters. Okay, so in this category, in this condition, this kind of floating structure platforms are very suitable, and that is why these platforms have been introduced in offshore industry. So the as we go below the topside deck, we will have something called as hull. So this hull is a synonym to the shipping hull. So here you will have buoyancy tanks, and how it works, that we will see. Below the hull we have the tension tendons, or the steel pipes. Okay, these are very high quality steel, which is a seawater resistant, seawater salt water resistant steel. At the same time, the diameters of the steel, it is basically a hollow kind of a pipe, and having a maximum major diameters of 64 inches or maybe more. Then these tension steel pipes are connected to the seabed by means of some pilings, which have been hammered by hydraulic hammers into the seabed, and on the top of these piles there is a kind of a hook or connecting arrangement. This arrangement connects the tension tendon with the template that is being installed on the seabed, and the top portion of the tension tendon is connected to the hull and the platform topside as a whole. Okay, so how this works? In the beginning, of course, you have the production and the flow lines, which are shown as production risers and wells. Okay, so how it works? First, the tension tendons are connected to the top side by means of some pivoting arrangement on the top. Then the second is the then those the bottom portion of this tension tendons are again attached or fastened to the template, but they are not fastened in a rigid sense, but in a flexible sense. similar to like that, what is what when it how it is like a pivot pin arrangement. So once these tension tendons are fixed to the platform and the template on the seabed, the hulls which are having the buoyancy arrangement, initially it will take all the sea water inside, and because of that the entire platform considering the top side will be heavier and will sink. So once it will sink, it is very easy to connect the tension tendons. Once the tendons are properly installed on their place, the portion of the buoyancy water is again thrown out, and as the water is taken out of the hull tanks, buoyancy tanks, slowly the platform will tend to float over the water, and as the platform moves upward, automatically the tendons or the steel pipes will get come under a severe tension, and this is how the platform will be locked in its place because of this tension. Okay, this tension can be adjusted by means of the buoyancy tanks, buoyancy water, quantity of buoyancy water inside the hulls, and this is how the platform works. Okay, this is a very interesting application wherein it has a combined scenario of the fixed platforms, because the tension plant tension tendons when under a tension because of this buoyancy arrangement exactly functions like a fixed platform, but still it will have the advantages of a flexible platform. Okay, so this is the arrangement. Then next we will see the spar. The spar arrangement is suitable for ultra deep waters, wherein we have a water depth of maximum up to 3000 meters, which is a 3 kilometers water depth. So we can imagine the structure. It has to be, it is compatible with the ultra deep waters. These platforms are very much familiar in the, these platforms are very much into the Pacific Ocean and into the Atlantics, where we have a very deep water column. So these platforms are, we can found it in good numbers. Okay, so here it's same almost 10% of the platform in spar is above the water where we can see, and the remaining rest of the platform is beneath the water, which is being shown. The complete arrangement of a tall column that is called as a spar. The spar is a synonym of or the spar is nothing but vertical big pillar kind of an arrangement in a ship. So it is similar to that. That is why this platform is called as a spar. Okay, this spar arrangement has similarly the buoyancy tank, and also it has arrangement to store the extracted hydrocarbons into the spar, which is the big round circular structure which is till the inserted submerged in the water, as well as which is on the above water, and on the top of that circular structure we have our platform installed, which is again having all the facilities of drilling, production, storage, accommodation, and all those things. Again, the bottom of this spar, the bottom of this spar is tethered or connected or tied by means of steel wire ropes, which are of made of high quality steel, and these ropes are tethered to the seabed by means of some fastening devices which are being hydraulically hammered into the seabed. So this is also a very interesting and important category of offshore platform. Moving ahead, we will see a semi-submersible platform. Semi-submersible platform is nothing but a kind of boat which is having a hull, and the top side of the boat is having all the facilities which are there on a regular platform. Again, it will have the communication mast, then helideck, drilling facility, drilling rig, derrick, power generation unit, accommodation, process platform, process unit, storage. That's it. So basically, these platforms are devised in ultra sea water depth. Here we can see that the water depth ranging from 60 meters to 3000 meters. So there is a wide range we can see for the water depth. And the basic advantage why we are using this is to 60 meter means in 60 meter we can go with the there may be a question that why we are using a semi-submersible platform, because if when we are using a floating structure, then we have, then there is some compromise with the stability of the platform. So why we are using that? We can go for a jacketed steel platform because the water depth is 60 meter. Here we need to take into account that it is not only the criteria of water depth. We have to also consider the quantity of hydrocarbon that is present in the reservoir. If it is a marginal reservoir, which will have a hydrocarbon that will can be extracted in say 1 month or say maybe 3 months, so it is not advisable to invest the steel structure, construction of a steel structure for extracting hydrocarbon that is only worth for three months. So in that case, we can go with this semi-submersible platform, which is same like a boat. It will be taken to the location where we have the reservoir, marginal reservoir, or maybe it can be in the deep waters also. Here in majority of the cases, if we have a deep water, there is a twin system. First is that we can have, if it is in shallow waters, like maybe 60 meter to say 500 meters, we can have arrangement of tension ropes which are connected, which are tethered to the seabed, and that may be the first option. Secondly, we also have for deep water DPS system, which is the dynamic positioning system, and it doesn't requires any kind of tethers or anchors. Basically, it is having kind of arrangement to position or lock the vessel at a particular location. So in coming session, we will see what actually the DPS system constitutes of and how it works. Okay, so today's session is completely separate from the scope of this dynamic positioning. We will see in next sessions. Okay, moving ahead, we will have this FPSO, that is the floating production storage offloading. So here it is exactly similar to the semi-submersible platform. And the only difference is the range of water depth. The FPSO is also applicable for ultra deep water, but it is having a more wider spectrum compared to the semi-submersible platform. Here you will have the water depth ranging from some 30 meter to 5000 meters. So it is up to 5 kilometers water depth. These kind of platforms are very common in the Bay of Bengal and also in the Ganga Sagar range and in Malaysia, where you have a comparatively higher water depth. It is the ultra water depth. So let's move ahead and see what the platform FPSO constitutes of. Here we have, it is exactly the same for the two basic function. First is the first governing factor is the water depth. If it is a higher water depth, then we can go for FPSO. Secondly, if we have a marginal reservoir wherein the extraction of the hydrocarbons may take maybe a month or maybe a 2 or 3 months. So in that case, we can go ahead with FPSO, as we have seen for the semi-submersible. So coming to the FPSO, we can see that FPSO is nothing but a barge, old barge or a ship, which is after useful life, it is converted into a drilling FPSO or a kind of a rig, FPSO rig. Okay, so it is having all the functions of a full-fledged platform. In addition to that, it is having a turret or the flexible or the turret transfer system, which we can see beneath the turret system. There is an arrangement of tethers, which are nothing but a high quality steel ropes. These steel ropes are connected, the top side, the top end of the rope is connected or tied to the FPSO, and the bottom of the rope is tethered to the seabed by means of some fastening devices which are hammered into the seabed. Okay. Moving ahead, we can see that on the back side of the FPSO, we are having an engine unit which is required for all the ships. In addition to that, the front side is having a heli deck which is there in all the types of platforms. Whenever this FPSO has a special advantage compared to the remaining platforms, and that is nothing but the capability to survive in harsh weather, whether it can be a tornado or it can be so in that case, what happens is that the as we can see that it is tethered to the seabed. And if there is a kind of some harsh environmental crisis, then those tethers are detached from the FPSO, and the FPSO moves forward like a ship. And this is how the platform can be again, the rig can be relocated to some other safe position. So this is all about the floating structures, oil rigs. So keep watching our channel. Keep watching our channel for some interesting updates on offshore oil sector. So if you can post your comments about this video in the comment section, and if you are interested for training in offshore, you can contact us on the credentials which are mentioned in that. And also don't forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel for getting the further updates about this kind of study video. Thanks for watching this video and stay connected. Thank you. In today's episode,